Hey guys, it's Lauren here, back again with another review of something I probably should have done a few weeks ago, but, Again, I sent in the Undertaker video the other day. I was sick the day I was going to record this review. I had a bad stomach ache, and again, threw up for the first time in a few years. Is that a good thing? I don't know, but you clicked on the video, so you're mine now. Either way, today we're looking. Let me start over. Today we're taking a look at the Super 7 Ultimate Comic Book Conan. This guy is basically a Motu Classics figure, but it's not Motu, it's Conan. So, yeah, pretty straightforward. If you're unable to follow that, well then, I don't know, add subtitles. But, yeah, a very controversial figure, especially mine, because the first one I got, the neck peg was frozen. This one, the neck peg was still frozen, but I managed to crack it and get it to move, so, yeah. It all worked out for me, didn't it? I still would argue against that. Either way, this figure was supposed to be out before this whole virus nonsense happened. I think this thing was supposed to be out way back in the winter, but there was a packaging issue, which, if you know me, packaging is the trash between me and my toys. So, yeah, let's just say our recycling bin fills up pretty quickly. Unless it's Mythic Legions box, because those have nice artwork. Either way, can't help it. Nate Barsh is awesome. Yeah, so these were delayed and delayed and delayed for packaging. It took them 4 months to do packaging. I don't know anything about what goes into making a figure like this, but I know that packaging should probably not take 4 months to do. I understand they had to ship them back, and then they had to get them back in the Chinese New Year, and the virus thing, and the blah blah blah, and the crazy reptile people, and the space aliens from Planet 9. Yeah, it's just a whole cluster. And, here we are. So, because we had to wait so long, we got a couple extra weapons. Now, these weren't packaged with the figure. These were packaged separately in their own little box, which I threw out the little box. Surprise. They are bloodstained versions of Conan's sword and spear. Let me move him out the way here, so he's not hogging all the focus. As you can see, they are nice and bloody. And some people are displaying their Conans with these. I think I'm going to display them with my Mythic Legions. Yeah. Because I can do that. Tee-hee! And as for Conan, the stuff he's supposed to come with, he also came with an alternate head. Which, this is actually the head he was packaged with. The alternate head I have on mine. I'm okay with this. It's supposed to be an angry face. Obviously, he's supposed to be like screaming like on the comic book. But it just looks awkward to me. I don't know. I don't dig it as much as the stoic and stern, I'm going to rip you a new asshole if you mess with me head sculpt that they did. First, they showed first, because this was the head that was on the prototype. That looks kick-ass. I don't know, but yeah. Awesome. So, other accessories. He comes with the sword. Standard fare. It's just a broadsword with a hilt. Kind of pointy hilt. Poke yourself. Hashtag don't break your toys and don't hurt yourself with your toys. And then he's got the spear, which he does hold on the comic cover. He's got some nice spawn spikes on there. Forgot to mention that. And he's got this knife, which pops off, but I'm going to try and avoid that because it's a bitch to get on there. So, yeah. Welcome to half-assed reviews. I don't get paid for this. That's why they're half-assed. So, articulation on this guy. If you got a Motu Classics, it's pretty much the same thing. Of course, nowadays, they started adding a little bit more articulation in the wrists and feet, so we will go over it quick. He does have a swivel in the head. It is a ball joint. it does kind of kick back forward and back a little bit, but it's hindered like the Skeletor I reviewed a while ago. The Franklin Jella Skeletor, his hood kind of hindered the hinge in the neck, so you can't really hinge it forward and back that much. And you can't really tilt either. So yeah, pretty limited. Mostly just a swivel, what you can get out of that. The necklace is a separate piece. You might be able to get a little bit more out of it if you were to take that off, but it's part of the design, so you can't do that, Lana. I'm sorry. Shoulders go out to the side a little bit past 90. They do rotate forward and back. That is nice. A bicep swivel. This thing will go all the way around, too. Hinge at the elbow. That'll give you a little bit less than 90. He's got a swivel at the wrist with a hinge. Both sides go in and out. None of them go up and down, kind of like we've been seeing on some of the Marvel Legends as of late. He's got an ab crunch. Try not to knock this knife off his hip. Crunches that far forward and that far back. He's got a waist swivel. That is nice. Hips can kick out to the side about that far. Almost a right angle, better than Spider-Man. And yeah. He can kick forward. He can kick forward farther than I thought. Not a right angle, but he can kick forward quite a bit. You will warp the loincloth, though, if you do that, so be wary. Kick back. He can kick back pretty far, too. Because, again, he's literally wearing a diaper made out of Yogi Bear. So, you ain't getting no picnic baskets today, boo-boo. He's got a thigh cut, which I think these have some of the better hip joints. The thigh kind of wraps up and around the hip joint, and they're pretty well hidden, all things considered. Mythic Legions has a similar style to this. He's got a single joint at the knee, which gives you about 90. I'd say, yeah, that's 90, right on the nose. And then his feet can hinge back. All the way, not more, and then forward a little bit if you want to screw with it. You can't really cheat. I wouldn't advise pushing it over that, but he does have a rocker joint, and they are nice and loose, but not to the point where they're going to be a problem. And this leg is a little warped on mine, I will say, but I don't think it's going to be a problem. A little heat, I'll fix that. I think it just needs to be compressed together, which I kind of feel like I'm fixing it now as I talk about it. So, yeah, that's Conan. Just a half-naked guy in a diaper and a cool-looking helmet. These spikes are pretty sharp on this helmet, too, by the way. So they will maintain their shape. Giving him his sword back. My sword actually has like a bit of a paint bubble on it. Right on that side, I don't think you can see that, but it's nothing that bad, so I'm not gonna worry about it. And there we go. And that's how you put a sword in the hand, kids. Yeah. Fail city. Let's actually get the sucker in the hand. There we go. It's got a nice tight grip on that thing too, so it's not gonna fall off. I should stop talking about tight sword grips. That sounds kind of suggestive. But there you go, Conan. Ready to kick some ass and sleep with wenches. What? totally not a character that would fly nowadays, but one that is regarded as one of the biggest badasses of fiction history, nonetheless. So, size comparison. We should compare him to the MOTU Classics body, obviously. Here he is next to Dolph Lundgren himself. Pretty cool. I'd say Dolph has a bit of height advantage here. Hold on, I'm messing around with my camera here. Here we go. Dolph does have some height on Conan, which is okay, because I'm, you know, they're going to be sitting by each other, but that's not really the intention. For my display, anyways, they're going to be in separate areas eventually. This guy is technically a Marvel Comics character, so I could put him with my Legends if I wanted to. Because it's my figure. I can do what I want. And then, for those of you old school collectors, here he is next to the Frank Frazetta style Conan that Toy Biz did about a decade ago at this point. Which, this figure is awesome. It does show its age in both its size and kind of wonky articulation in spots. It just doesn't look as nice and clean as this. But that's okay. This is still a nice look for Conan. I do still like this figure. But, yeah. And then last but not least, as far as Conan comparisons, because this is the only other Conan figure you can buy in the scale right now, as far as I know. That is Ral, the Devourer of Souls. Who is frickin' badass. And I could see these two going at it. They're pretty close to the same height. I mean, Ral is supposed to be a bigger character, and for those of you who are curious, you can pop his helmet off. And he's pretty much Spawn. Yep, he's pretty much Spawn. Mixed with a jack-o'-lantern, but nonetheless. Pretty cool. Love that figure. Thank you, T-Biz. You got shoutouts in the last video. What the hell? Couple more size comparisons. You know, I got to do the standards. The Overlord Productions standards. Let's grab the right figure. Probably not by the head. That's not a good idea. Here he is next to the Mighty Spawn, who he does not compare to still. This figure is on another level. Seriously. It's that amazing. And here he is next to Ghost Rider. There you go. So, you can have him square off against Spawn. He's probably about the same height as Spawn, but Spawn's just a cooler figure. Because it's Spawn! Love that figure. It's amazing! Should buy it, especially now that you can buy it at Target with an axe. Kind of looks cooler in the sword, but I digress. So Conan, cool figure. A little bit of a controversy, but this gives me hope that Super 7 is going to branch out and do other things with the Ultimates line. Like, I don't know, King Diamond? Hell yes! yeah, I am pre-ordering that sucker as soon as I finish recording some videos today. That thing looks amazing. It sucks it's going to be a long wait, slated to come out third quarter next year. Which, I don't know, maybe they'll develop something new to screw with us all by then. Am I right? No. But, yeah. I'd like to see lots of other metal characters with the Ultimates treatment. I think a Judas Priest, Painkiller Angel, or the Slayer guy is kind of warranted. That'd be nice. They've been doing a lot of wrestling, so it's nice to see that they're doing the metal stuff, because I think that's really what Super 7's best at, is that metal stuff. I mean, I bought most of the reaction figures, or I have a lot of the reaction figures. Still waiting on my Papa Emeritus, though. Kind of pissed about that, but nonetheless. We're not talking about that stuff. We're talking about Conan. Cool figure. If you like Conan, pick it up. If not, well, then I don't know what to tell you. I think this is a nice piece to put with your classics, your multi-classics. I think it's a nice piece to put with your Marvel Legends, because it is a Marvel licensed character, at least this interpretation. And, you know, if you just like half-naked dudes who kill people violently and wear nothing but Yogi Bear's fur on their crotch, then by all means, pick it up. But with that being said, hope you guys enjoyed this review, and until next time, I'll catch you guys later. And stay tuned, because eventually I'm going to be reviewing this guy, but it's Arnold Schwarzenegger. Is it vice versa?